Okay, students of class 4, welcome back once again to the e-learning class. This is your science class. We have completed our PT1 syllabus. So I am starting the term 1 syllabus. Remember, term 1 includes PT1 also. So in your term 1 syllabus, chapter 1 and 2 are also there. We have completed chapter 1 and 2. So I am starting chapter number 3, which is chapter of your term 1 syllabus. So chapter 3 is safety and first aid. So before starting the chapter, what should come in our mind? Which question? What are safety rules? Question is, what are safety rules? So what is the answer? Safety rules are the rules that to be followed to avoid accidents. So safety rules are the rules which should be followed to avoid accidents. Now let us start another question. It can also, why do accidents occur? Why do, question number 2, why do accidents occur? So you know, accidents occur anytime, anywhere, due to our carelessness and also if you do not follow the safety rules. So accidents can occur anytime, anywhere, due to our carelessness and if you do not follow the safety rules. So let us start. It is page number 17 in your book. You should have your chapter open. Okay. See here, accidents may occur anytime, anywhere without giving any warning. We often get hurt at home, in school, in the playground or on the road. Most of the accidents occur due to our carelessness. We should follow safety rules to avoid accidents. Now, safety rules to be followed at home. Safety rules at home. Sleeping on the floor. A wet floor is dangerous and can harm you. You may slip or fall on the wet floor easily. To avoid such accidents, we should follow these safety rules. So, a wet floor, if water has fallen there or if any oil has spilled there, okay, it should be dangerous for us. We may slip or fall there. To avoid such accidents, we should follow these safety rules. What are the safety rules to be followed? Number one, keep the floor dry. Okay, we should keep always the floor dry. Number two, floors of the kitchen and the bathroom should not be slippery. Floors of kitchen and bathroom should not be slippery. Number three, never leave your toys on the floor or stairs. You may trip over them. So we should never, when we are playing with the toys, we should not leave the toys there. We should arrange the toys in a proper way, in the proper place. Then we should go. We should never leave our toys on the floors or the stairs. You may trip over them. Now, fire in the kitchen. Accidents due to fire in the kitchen can cause serious injury. To avoid such accidents, we should follow these safety rules. So accidents in the due to fire in the kitchen can occur. Okay, it is very dangerous there and severe injury can come. To avoid such accidents, we should follow these safety rules. Number one, in case of a gas leakage, open the doors and the windows to let the gas out. In case of a gas leakage, open the doors and the windows to let the gas out. Do not light matchsticks or turn on electric switches at the time of gas leakage. So if there is a gas leak, you can smell the gas. If there is a gas leak, you should open the doors and the windows. to let the gas out, then you should not light any matchsticks there, or you should not turn on the electric switches at the time. Number two, do not pick up anything from a burning gas stove. You should not pick up anything from a burning gas stove. Number three, do not wear synthetic clothes while working in the kitchen. We should not wear synthetic clothes while working in the kitchen. They can catch fire easily. Yes, synthetic clothes, they can catch fire easily. So we should not wear synthetic clothes while we are working in the kitchen, while we are cooking. Number four, never play with things made of glass. Never play with things made of glass. They can break easily and cause cuts and wounds. So you should never play with things made of glass. They can break easily and cause cuts and wounds. Next is electric shocks. Electrical appliances are very useful to us, but if you handle them carelessly, they can be dangerous and may give electric shocks. To avoid electric shocks, you should follow these safety rules. What are the safety rules to be followed? Number one, do not touch any electrical appliance or switch with wet hands or barefoot. Okay, you should remember never to touch any electrical appliance or switch with wet hands. It can give you a severe shock. Also, you should not be barefooted there. Number two, do not go close to heaters or table fans when they are on. Turn off the switches before touching them. So you should not go close to heaters or table fans when they are on. Turn off the switches before touching them. Turn to next page, page number 18 now. Come to page number 18. Number 2, same point, that one, electric shocks. Point number 3 is there for electric shocks. Do not touch a damaged wire. If you see a damaged wire, if it is open there, the casing from the plastic, it is open, you should not touch the damaged wire. Number 4, when someone gets an electric shock or you notice a spark, turn off the main switch immediately. So when someone gets an electric shock or you see some sparking there, you should turn off the main switch immediately. Poisoning, to avoid poisoning, we should follow these safety rules. Number one, never take any medicine unless your parents or a doctor gives it to you. Yes, it is very important. You should not take any medicine by yourself. You should ask the elder or your parents, or if a doctor prescribed it, you should take those medicine. Number two, all poisonous chemicals like floor cleaners and detergent should be kept away from the children. All poisonous chemicals like floor cleaners and detergent should be kept away from the children. Number three, do not eat stale, spoiled and exposed food. It can cause food poisoning. Yes. The food which is kept for a long time, if it is not covered properly or not kept in the refrigerator, you should not take those food. It may get damaged, it may get poisoning. So, do not eat any stale food or exposed food. It can cause food poisoning. So, there is another safety rules in the playground. Safety rules in the safety rules you should follow in the playground. So what are the safety rules you should follow in the playground? Let us see. We must be very careful while playing. We should follow these safety rules in the playground. So while you are playing on the ground, you should follow some safety rules. So what are those safety rules? Let us see. Point number one, do not push or hit each other while playing. Yes, important. Do not push or hit each other while playing. Number two, do not play rough games. Do not play any rough games. Number three, stay away from the swings when someone is using them. Stay away from the swings when someone is using them. Number four, do not jump from the seesaw without informing your partner. So, if you are playing on the seesaw, do not jump immediately. Do not jump all of a sudden. You should inform your partner there, then you should jump. Do not jump from the seesaw without informing your partner. So, these are the safety rules you should follow in the playground. So, students, today up to this much we have revised. See you in the next class with the next portion of the revision, this chapter 3, safety and first aid. We have started the term 1 syllabus. So, see you again. Bye.